34th Sutra of the Kaivalyapada, the last Sutra of the Patanjali Yoga Sutras, and the ultimate, the final Sutra of the Patanjali's Yoga Darshana. The Sutra is Purushartha Sunyanam Gunanam Pratiprasavaha Kaivalyam Sarupa Pratishthava Chitishaktiriti. Purushartha Sunyanam Gunanam Pratiprasavaha Kaivalyam Sarupa Pratishthava Chitishaktiriti. Purushartha Sunyanam Gunanam Pratiprasavaha Kaivalyam Sarupa Pratishtha Va Chiti Shaktir Iti. Purushartha, Purusha Artha. It has two meanings, Purushartha's, which we generally know, Chaturvidha Purushartha's. And that also, that meaning, actual meaning of Purushartha's is for the purpose of the Purusha. Here it is the same, Purushartha, Purusha Artha. Purpose of Purusha. Shunya is devoid, shunyam, vacant, empty, shunyanam, gunanam, trigunas, plural, shunyanam, gunanam, prati prasava, prati is counter, prasava is evolution, counter evolution, involution it is, kaivalya, absoluteness, Sva, one's own, Rupa, form, Svarupa, one's own form, Pratishtha, established, reinstatement, Va, or Chiti Shakti, Chit Shakti, the potentiality of Chiti, it is not Chitta, Chiti. The unmanifest potentiality. And this is the end. Iti, the end it is. The general understanding of the sutra is the pratiprasava of gunas, which are devoid of any purpose, to be served for the Purusha, that is Kaivalya, is established in their own potentiality of Chiti. That is the final meaning. So Kaivalya is the state, though this sutra is not definition, but we have to say it is a definition. As said earlier, the indescribable is described, the indefinable is defined for our own understanding. Kaivalya is the state of enlightenment following the re-emergence of the gunas because of their becoming devoid of the object of the Purusha. In this state, the Purusha is established in his real nature, which is pure consciousness. Kaivalya is the culmination of a tremendously long evolutionary process, extending over innumerable lives and involving enormous periods of time. It is not just a shortcut or a short time, a long unending process of sadhanas, a long extending over innumerable lives and involving enormous periods of time, completely one after the other. The gunas, the samskaras, the vasanas, the karmas, the prarabdha karmas, the agami karmas, yes, the sanchita karmas, the entire gunas have been lost, trigunatitaha, nirgunatvaha, nishkamaha, nishkarmyaha. Yes, that is the state. It is worth to remember the Mandukya Upanishad, which beautifully says that particular state of the sthiti that wonderful state of the Purushaha. Though terminology used in the Vedanta and the Mandukya Upanishad is different, but we can easily correlate for our understanding of the Kaivalyaha, Kaivalya Sthitihi, the re-established Pratishtha, the word used by Maharshi Patanjali. He has used this word beautifully, Pratishtha. Swarupa Pratishtha it is called. Kaivalya is Swarupa Pratishtha. And Chitishakti, all powerful it is. And that is out of the Purushartha Sunya and Guna Pratiprasavaha it is called. Purushartha Sunya and Guna Pratiprasavaha it is. This Sunya is also implies to not only to the Purushartha Sunya, it is also to Guna Sunya it is. Pratiprasava Sunya it is. And finally, Kaivalya is Pratishtha or the Swarupaha it is. And then the all pervasive Chiti Shakti is the Kaivalyaha. The Mandukya Upanishad beautifully summarizes its own seventh mantra of the Mandukya Upanishad. Nantah prajnam, nantah prajnam, nabahish prajnam, nobayata prajnam, na prajnana ghanam, na prajnam, na prajnam, adrishtam avyavaharyam agrahyam alakshanam, achintyam avyapadeshyam, ekatma pratyayasaram, prapanchopashamam, shantam, shivam, advaitam, chaturtham, manyante sa atma savijnyaha. Na antah prajnam, na bahish prajnam, na ubhayatah prajnam, na prajnana ghanam. Neither inner awareness, outer awareness, neither the awareness of anything. Na prajnam, not even the awareness. Na prajnam, not even the non-awareness. It is adrishtam. It is avyavaharyam. It is agrahyam. It is alakshanam. It is achintyam. It is avyapadeshyam. It is ekatmam. It is pratyayam. Pratyayasaram. It is prapancha upashamam. What a beautiful description. The Kaivalya Sthiti of Maharshi Patanjali is exactly an image or the Upanishads and the Yoga Darshana, they echo their messages. Upanishad echoes the Yoga Darshana and Yoga Darshana echoes the message of the Upanishads. Many of the sadhakas feel the ultimate of the Vedanta and the Yoga are different. It is not. It is the same. One says the Brahma, Brahman. One says it is the Purusha. Terminologies are different. But it is the one and the same. And what is the state? Mandukya Upanishad. It is the Shantam. It is the Shivam. It is Advaitam. Chaturtham manya ante sa atma savinyeha. That is to be understood. That is to be realized. And what Maharshi Patanjali said in this last sutra, Purushartha sunyanam gunanam pratiprasavaha kaivalyam sarupa pratishthava chitishaktiriti. It's one and the same it is. So, the ultimate of the Vedanta, the ultimate of the Yoga is the same. One is establishment in oneself, says as the Brahmatvam, and here it is said as the Purushattvam it is. The message of the Sanatana Dharma, the goal of the Sanatana Dharma, the purpose of the Sanatana Dharma is this realization of one's own self it is. Yoga called it as Purushaha, and Vedanta calls it as the Brahman. The Brahman is Gunatitaha. The Purusha is Gunatitaha. The Brahman is Naiskarmya Sthiti. The Purushaha is Naiskarmya Sthiti. And this understanding is very, very important for all the sadhakas, for all the teachers of the yoga, and for all the Vedantists. And Swami Vivekananda, in his masterly way, concludes the entire Yoga Sutras in his brilliant way. An absolute freedom comes from the qualities, the gunas, becoming devoid of the object of the Purusha, and become latent, or the power of consciousness becomes established in its own nature. This is also the message of the Vedanta. In fact, all the Shad Darshanas, Sankhya, Nyaya, Vaisheshika, and of course the Vedanta and this Yoga, all lead to the same goal. Methods may be different, explanations may be different, but all point to that one and the same which is there in the entire world, including, of course, we cannot exclude ourselves. It is in me. And this message that we as a human beings and the entire world and the creation are all the manifestations, expressions of one single force. Maybe named as different. The one God, the one Lord, the Brahman, the Purusha, the Brahman of the Vedanta, the Purusha of the Yoga, the God and the Lord of the Puranas and the Bhakti is one and the same. Let us conclude with the concluding commentary of Swami Vivekananda. Swami Vivekananda, the resolution in the inverse order of the qualities, perfect bereft of any motive of action for the Purusha, is Kaivalya, or it is the establishment of the power of knowledge in its own nature. Nature's task is done. This unselfish task which our sweet nurse nature had imposed upon herself, as it were, she gently took the self-forgetting soul by the hand and showed him all the experiences in the universe, all the manifestations, bringing him higher and higher through various bodies till his glory came back and he remembered his own nature. Then the kind mother went back the way she came for others who have also lost their way in the trackless desert of life. And thus she is working without beginning and without end. And thus through pleasure and pain, through good and evil, the infinite river of souls is flowing into the ocean of perfection, of self-realization. Glory unto those who have realized their own nature. May their blessings be on all of us. That is how Swami Vivekananda concludes. Om Shanti Shanti Shanti.